I want to start with some big ideas from you. What's going to be the next big bet for the National Bank of Bahrain in an industry that's facing headwinds globally?
I would say to start with, in the banking industry, we don't like to take bets, especially when we are traditionally a retail bank. Having said that, we have embarked over the past 2 years into a transformation, modernization of the National Bank of Bahrain. It's a bank which is a solid bank with a very large, very broad clientele base, but with the changes in the banking industry, both in terms of regulations, in terms of technology, and very importantly, to follow the requirements of our clients, we thought it was time to transform the way we do business. So it's not really a bet because it's part of a strategy, but it's a strategy which is constructed on various pillars. Modernization in terms of clients' touch points in the retail side, you know, to ensure that we can accommodate the requirements of the new generation, that we can facilitate financial transactions for our retail clients. Yeah. It's a big job because we have a lot of clients. We are the largest retail clientele base in the country, so it's important that we do it in a seamless way and that we manage to attract new clients. But that's not the only strategic direction. Obviously, it's visible because of the branches, the products, the online banking. But one of our pillars for the future is to be more active in the local economy, to be leading larger financing transactions, projects, infrastructure, industry for the country. And that is something which now the National Bank can do.
I was going to follow up on exactly that in terms of your plans for growth from things like project finance and not so much investment banking. I mean, how do these fit into the equation for the road ahead?
First of all, we have created a new business line, which is corporate institutional investment banking. So we have, we don't do only structured finance. We also have the capability to help our clients to manage their risks, for example. We are able to manage their flows. So it's a more comprehensive approach to the client. But to answer the questions, we don't do project finance for the sake of doing project finance. We do project finance to finance the projects in the countries or certain countries in the GCC for our clients. And clients can be government, can be large corporates, and we don't do only the structured finance, hence your question on the investment banking. Our ambitions is to be top of mind as a local bank for all these large borrowers. So, it's also to do with capital markets. We've been involved lately in lead arranging bond issues for the government, but also for entities like Mumtalakat. It's also, as I mentioned earlier, risk management, interest rates risks, structuring risk, and so on. So it's a global approach, but we believe that as a national bank, we need to be leading some projects. We cannot be followers, we need to be leaders.
You recently abandoned plans to acquire the Bahrain Islamic Bank. In a statement, you said that you want to maintain the current shareholding in the bank without pursuing a voluntary offer at this stage. You remain committed to the future growth and development of BISB, as the bank is known. Why did you decide to do that?
Well, first of all, I reiterate what you say. It's for us, it's we are already shareholders, and we are committed to the success of this bank. It's obviously in the interests of everybody, the shareholders, the bank itself, and the country. Now, we've studied, and we've mentioned we have updated the market on a regular basis. We have studied this opportunity. We thought that the timing was not right. It doesn't mean that we have abandoned. It means that at this point in time, we thought it was probably worth waiting because both banks have their strategies and to find a better timing for an eventual transaction in the future.
We're seeing the industry in the region undergo a wave of consolidation and mergers and acquisitions. The United Arab Emirates and Saudi Arabia and other parts of the Gulf Cooperation Council. What's the story in Bahrain from where you're sitting? Is there scope for more consolidation given how small the market is and how capped your organic growth really is?
I believe that there is room for consolidation in Bahrain, even if it's a small market, or maybe because it's a small market. Now, because it's a small market, consolidation might come with other countries as well, with cross-border types of consolidation, as we have seen, for example, KFH and AUB, although they have some common shareholding in Kuwait. But it's a good example of cross-border transactions. So I believe that the trend of consolidation is necessary. It's necessary because investments in banking are growing, and you know the critical mass is important. Mm-hmm. And the development of new technology, development of new approaches to clients requires, I would say, more critical mass. So I would think that Bahrain, like the other countries of the GCC, Saudi, UAE, will see at some stage some consolidation.
So are you in talks with anybody at all, or are you open to that kind of conversation?
We are a bank which is, as I said, transforming. We are looking at developing new businesses, and we have proven that. Islamic banking could be one. So we have been looking at opportunities, but for the time being, we have no specific ones. But are we open? Yes, definitely we are open to new ideas.